Here at NASA's Stennis Space Center, where we test rocket engines and their components, ball and globe valves are used to provide high pressure gases and liquids to conduct these tests.
These are not standard off-the-shelf valves. This is a custom ball valve built for our high pressure, high flow application. It's rated at 15,000 PSI and about 900 pounds mass per second of gas flowing through it. This is the actuator for the valve, and this is the ball valve that we use. It's got hundreds of parts in this ball valve in order to make it work. When we originally procured these valves, we got 2 to 3 cycles out of the valve before it broke. We had to take it to the shop and rebuild it. Through extensive modification and redesign, we've got this valve up to about 20 to 30 cycles before we have to rebuild it. Relating that to your shower valve, 2 to 3 cycles would mean you get to take 2 showers, and then you have to rebuild your valve in order to take the next shower. Neither way is acceptable to me, so I invented the valve with 5 parts and much simpler to operate with much longer life.
This valve is distinct from other valves in that it uses a floating piston inside the body of the valve to open and close the valve. The piston opens and closes with the same force every time. Doesn't matter what the pressure is inside the valve or what the pressure drop across the valve is, the piston only is going to see the forces we want it to see and is going to always open and close with the same force. It is accomplished through the use of a balancing chamber and careful design of the interior surface areas so that they completely cancel each other out. The design also eliminates the need for a valve stem that penetrates through the valve body in order to move the plug against the seat. By doing this, the need for stem seals and even a conventional actuator are eliminated. In addition to increasing reliability, the elimination of stem seals also eliminates a leakage path along those seals. This is a leading cause of fugitive emissions, which the EPA is very actively trying to limit. With the simplified design, commercial industries should be able to see lower costs with the elimination of a conventional actuator and fewer parts and simpler parts to fabricate. Because of the elimination of the stem and stem seals and constant closing force, the valve should have a significant life improvement, which will lead to fewer repairs and longer intervals between outages. The demonstrator valve that we built and tested was cycled over 600 times with no signs of wear. Industries such as gas and oil, or any chemical or gas producing industry, will be able to find significant advantages from the use of this valve.
This NASA technology and many others are ready to be transferred to your business. Find out more by visiting technology.nasa.gov.